Welcome back to Ukko Plays Hearthstone Arena. Here we are again with our Warlock deck. Surprisingly, 3 victories, no losses. Let's keep playing. Well. I wonder how long can I go without a loss. Hopefully long enough. But I'm kinda worried that I'm starting to run into really good decks now. Since I don't know how they decide who you play, but I think I'm going against really good decks now who have also not lost really games. I'm Ramos. Alright. You know what? This is actually a pretty nice start. Yeah, I'll go with all these. I could have maybe thrown away the Shield Master, but why throw it away? It's a nice 4 mana card. Well, it's gonna be a Voidwalker now. Why do you call? I should greet him. Greetings. So.
It's time for a little blood.
Oh, that's annoying, but luckily I have my Shadow Bolt. Okay, so. My options. He has 4 damage on the board. If I drop this guy, what happens? Well, he cannot kill this guy without, like, doing... Yeah, he can actually kill it using his...
So many possibilities.
Also, should I just coin Shadow Bolt this guy? It's a lot of cards to take care of one card, but... In case he can, like, buff it or something, I probably... That's probably the best thing I can do here. You know, he might have had some Mark of the Wild coming there. Mark of the Wild, is that... That's really cheap, isn't it? Like 2 mana. I think. Okay, inner right. Well, he could have casted something really big here.
Get behind me.
Booty Bay. And not bad. Okay, so Booty Bay will kill just about anything here. Buffing this guy up, kind of pointless. I could just life tap and play this guy. So then he'll kill this dude with the Booty Bay and kill the imp with
so
one.
Many possibilities.
With the Worgen, I think. But I think that's like the best thing I can do. So let's life tap and play the Flame Imp. I mean, I want to have something on the board here. It's pretty easy for him to play now. As I said, just kill my taunt with his taunt and then kill the Flame Imp with the Worgen. Yeah, I think that is what we'll see here. Yeah.
The light protects me.
1-1 Divine Shielded. Not too worried about that. One good thing is that he is pretty low on cards compared to me. Annoying thing is this guy, he can one-shot anything. Anything. Oh, Soulfire. Should I blow a Soulfire? I think I should drop this guy and then blow a Soulfire. Or should I drop the Yeti? If I drop the Yeti, then... I'll drop the Yeti and kinda... And hope I don't lose my Dust Dingo here. Voodoo Doctor, like, that was the most worthless. That was... Most worthless? Is that... is that good English? That was, the worst card I had there, so I'm happy it chose that thing. I think he's just doing damage to me. Okay, makes sense. No. Do I want a taunt? I can also buff up this guy and just hit him. The 1-1 is not that dangerous here. Yeah. I think I'll just keep dropping shit on the board and see what he does. I mean, if we're racing now, he's gonna be losing more health than me when you look what we have on the board here. So I can kill the 2-2 using the 1-1 and his hero power, but that's such a waste of mana from his side, I think. So, we'll see. I mean, I guess the conservative thing would have been to go with the Sealed Master so I stop any damage coming to me, but I felt like I wanted to have like more damage on the board here, so this is somewhat of a dangerous looking board now. Especially if he cannot deal with it in any way. So we'll see. Swipe? Well... wonder if he can... he can't do anything to the Yeti. So he blew a big removal there. Worked pretty well on him. But luckily, I still have something really good. Oh, how perfect, Mortal Coil. Do I even... yeah, I'm gonna... yeah, let's not even play my Sealed Master. It's not like he has much on the board, so... first of all, Mortal Coil is good. Argus. Yeah, I'd like to have an Argus, actually, but next. Buff this guy up. And I think I'll just life tap. I feel brave enough to life tap. Abomination is a pretty nice thing. So I have a bunch of taunt up options now. If these guys survive, I'll probably do an Argus. They don't. Again, he blows a pretty big removal on a Yeti. And he blows another removal. Not quite as big to take care of that guy. Almost wanna play Abomination now, though. Oh, wonder if he can remove this guy. I don't think he can. But he's at 7 mana. At 8 mana he can play the 8-8 taunt. It would be safer to play this dude, though.
So many possibilities.
Yeah, that's the question. I will play this guy and see what he does. It's a bit of a dangerous play, depending on what he has, but I mean, this is arena. I cannot count on him having the 8-8 taunt. Ironbark Protector, is it? So, we'll see. If he cannot remove this guy, then I'll be having a pretty nice Shield Master and everything on the board. So, let's see. Ensure not poor, okay. That's not a... oh, I don't wanna destroy this guy. So... I don't wanna make this guy a taunt, though. So do I... yeah, I cannot... I can drop these two guys, but... well, this guy does not die if I buff him with Argus. Thing is, I don't know what he has in there. If he has some buff cards, then I may not do so well. It's gonna sucks to throw. Let's see. This guy will become 5/5, and yeah, but his explosion will make sure that this guy dies if I attack him directly. Then, I think I have to go Shield Master and then give Argus buff to the Shield Master for some extra buffing. Then, should I attack this guy? I don't think I should. I really don't think I should. Because I'm really afraid he has another Moonfire there, or that AoE thing that does two damage to all. I still have Twisting Nether in my hand, but I don't really want to blow it when I have the board control. Well, more or less the board control.
What to do?
I love my Shadow Ball. Oh, okay, Silence comes out. Well, that does not do that much yet. And I can now throw this guy at the 5/10 without having to worry about. Yeah, I'll definitely kill the taunt now. Oh, Sea Giant. Perfect, I can drop Sea Giant and then Abomination, I think. Okay, how am I gonna do this? First of all, this guy needs to come down. Then I start trading. This guy beats this dude. Let's see. I think this guy just hits. The thing is, if I drop the Abomination, him dying will kill almost all. I mean, this guy, if and when I attack something like this. He only has 6 damage, so I'm gonna go with Venture Co and see what happens. I still have this Abomination as kind of a oh shit card here. So, we'll see. And he may feel like he's forced to trade with the, at least with the 6-1. And do I have any Brewmasters on this deck? I don't think I have any Brewmasters, so... Well, here comes Starfall, I was kinda afraid of this, but... I still have 2 kinda dangerous minions on the board. So I'm guessing he may wanna kill the... giant rather than the... Oh. Can he... Interesting. Oh, the Cobra. Yeah, I don't think he should. Okay, what should I do? Should I freeze the Cobra? I should freeze the Cobra, probably. Now let's see, if I don't do anything to the Cobra, I could attack this guy and then just let the Cobra attack this dude next. I also have to think about the damage. He has no cards, though. If I drop this dude, what happens? He'll trade with the 4-4. I mean, I could drop... Yeah, if I kill the 4-4 with this guy, then this dude has 2 health. And once again, it dies to the... Oh, so annoying. Okay. I'll freeze the Cobra. And I'll kill the 4-4. And I definitely will not a life tap right now. Next turn I kinda have to trade the 5-5 with the Cobra. The good thing is he may be able to silence the Cobra, but that silence will also remove the poison effect. So I'm not worried about that. Actually have 2 oh shit cards here. The Twisting Nether is the bigger oh shit card. I think I'll only use it if he plays like a Deathwing or something. If he had a Deathwing on his hand, he would have probably played it already. So the question is, what will he do?
What to do? Someone called.
Voodoo Doctor is kinda pointless. It does make it kinda annoying to me now. Power overwhelming. I don't wanna give power overwhelming to anyone. Thing is... Yeah, I think I have to like... Wait, can I kill him? No, I cannot kill him, he's far too... Yeah, this guy has to kill the Cobra, but... But I need... I mean... You know what? This guy cannot actually kill this dude yet, so... So I'll do this and attack him. That maybe buys one more turn to my giant to do damage. No, I kinda feel like I have to... Wait. Okay, it's a friendly minion that I have to attack. Yeah. Okay, he does that. I should definitely shadow bolt this dude. Right? No power overwhelming. Let's see how much I have. 12 damage, so I would go to 16 damage. That's not quite enough yet. I'll shadow bolt this dude. I'll hit to beat him. Let's play a bit of a risky deal and a life tap too. Okay. These guys are at low health, but... yeah, he's dead. He's dead. I can just power overwhelming this guy. And a victory! 4th victory in a row, hey! I'm pretty happy. Did I give him well play? I think I did. Yay! Golden Sacrificial Pact. Too bad the Sacrificial Pact is kind of a bad card. In some cases it may be good, but hey, 4 victories, let's keep playing. Alright. I'm thinking who I... don't think I have seen... Have I seen mages yet on this Warlock deck? Well, we'll see now, we'll see now. Eh, mage. Eh, roses. Okay, we'll see how I'll do now. I go first, well, that means the flame imp has to go. Yeah, it could be good, but... Let's try to maybe get something better. Well, okay. I didn't even remember I had two of these. But hey, Venturer, I don't really wanna play it that much. Now you can like coin Frostbolt to kill this guy. And no. Well, he coined and used a kind of a shitty Warlock to kill that dude. I don't know who came up ahead there. Oh no. I don't wanna play Succubus when I have stuff like this in my hand. But I'm gonna have to maybe. Yeah, that guy is not a danger to my Succubus, so... I could play this dude, but... Could also play this dude, but... again, meh. I'll play this guy and see. It's kinda sad since I have a bunch of good cards in my hand, but... Okay, lost the Argus. Argus is a good card, but I feel like I kinda had to, instead. Well, maybe I didn't had to, but I really wanted to get a decent minion out. He'll just be pinging it. And if that dude doesn't buff itself. Abomination, I feel like I should just give this guy +1/+1 and kill that dude.
We must cleanse the sun well.
And once again, he cannot ping down the 5-2 now. He can ping it once again and hope to get it down next turn, but... Yeah, that's an annoying card. And drain life. Anything else I could play? Not really. Could get this dude up to 6. Now if I leave this dude up, he'll just kill the 5-2. I could also drop this dude. Problem is all my dudes are at 2 health, so when this dude dies he would also kill all my board. There are things I could once again buff this guy up, but he'd still die next turn from this guy's attack and the fireball. Maybe I should buff this dude up so it's not quite as easy for them to think who to attack. Yeah, maybe. I could also kill this dude actually with drain life and... Is it worth draining life on this guy? I mean, it's not that dangerous. I would lose this dude still. Yeah, I think I'll just buff up this guy. And attack them. And I'll life tap once again. Rockwell. Eh, possibly useful. Okay. I would imagine they want to kill the 5-2 with the 2-7. Yeah. So, what do they have? A bunch of cards, at least 6 cards there, so... I would imagine there's something they can play. I mean, I guess a 3-2 and 4-3 are kind of annoying things on the board. They can probably kill most of things that he can play. What's this? Aiming at themselves. Some sort of a heal? Okay. Yeah. That's probably the way to go. Okay, let's think about this. Oh, I can kill this dude with my Mortal Coil. Yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. Anything else I could do? I could also kill this guy with my Drain Life. I wonder if it... Does it work like that? I don't know. Let's see. Yeah. So, should I blow both of these here? Blow this on this dude first and see. I mean, why you say minion when I can save that minion? Yeah.
Push forward.
Okay, 6 mana. Next turn is the flame strike turn. Will be interesting to see what will happen. Next turn is also Stormwind Champion turn. for me. Depending on what they play. Okay, they freeze the floor too with a... And that is a pretty annoying thing actually to do. Okay. No, none of these are demons, so I could like... Let's see, if I drop this guy, I would still need to sacrifice both of these. Well, I could drop this guy and sacrifice like the 2-2 after demon fire. Actually, I could not since I don't have the mana for that. But I can drop... Yeti? I can also drop this guy, but I'm once again really scared of the possible flame strike. So I think Yeti... Yeti demon fire and then throw this guy away. Could also throw this guy away, but I don't have that many spells. I already blew a bunch of them. So I think I'll do that. I have no demons in here anyway. Demon fire and kobold. You served your cause well. I think that's a very debatable thing. Should I have killed the kobold or this 3-2 dude? I opted to keep the one with the higher damage, so... Is it a flame strike coming? No, it's just a venture co. Another... Alright, how am I gonna deal with this now? I don't really have to deal with it this turn. Yeah, this dude will kill it next turn with this guy out, or I drop... Yeah, but him running the venture co into this dude would... Kill this 3-2 now. If I drop this guy, I get 5 attack on this, so it's not enough. Other options, drop this guy and this dude. Kind of a bad play in my opinion. I feel like I should just freeze him. And honestly, one more life tap. Moral coil. Not bad. Push forward.
Well played.
And they're in a bad spot now, 7 health. Frost Nova. Fire Blast. That dude. No. Yeah. Yeah. Could I buff this guy up really high? I'm gonna go drop this dude and then like, let's see, one damage, I mean, you could kill this dude and draw a card, but that's kind of a, feels like a bad idea. I'm almost feeling like dropping the abomination now. Could drop this guy and the abomination, but then he would just kill him. Well, I mean, this guy, abomination, so another taunt. Abomination dying would still reduce lots of these guys to really low health. I think that's still the best way to go.
Give me a quest.
Just spam the board. I mean, he may have like a... He may have that flame strike coming. I mean, this would be a perfect board for his flame strike now. It would kill everything. And there it comes. Yeah, that was not a very good thing to see. Maybe I should have, Cold Master. Well, this is a kind of a bad spot now. Well, Stormy Champion goes out. A good Mortal Coil, but what good does that do? Nothing. Let me guess, Pyroblast. Well, well played. My big mistake was spamming my board there, even though he could have easily had a flame strike, and he did indeed have a flame strike. But hey, that's Hearthstone. Anyway, this was Ukko playing Hearthstone Arena. Until next time.